do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by, now I'm going to stop there, and transformed will just take a second. Now, I want this to kind of sink in real deep for you. In Romans chapter 8, starting in verse 29, he says, those whom he foreknew, he also predestined. Don't get worried about that word predestined. If you look it up in the Greek, it simply means to be predetermined, to be predestined, all right? And so in that text, he says, those whom he foreknew, he also predestined. Now look right at me, to be conformed to the image of his son, which means that before anything existed, God knew you, God loved you, and God's plan for you was to shape and mold you into the image of Jesus Christ. And God is about that business. And hear me, he will send you both joy and sorrow to get you there. To get you where? Into the image of his son. Now look at how he says, your kind of passive action in this works. Let's look at it. But be transformed. Listen to how we are transformed. By the renewal of your mind. Now, remember how I said at the beginning that you're not transformed by going, this is a behavior I'd rather not do. So let me take all my energy, all my vitality, and all my life, and let me pour it into conquering this behavior. But what he said right here is, no, man, your brain's broke. The reason you're going after that thing is you're broken. So the question we need to answer here is, how do you renew your mind? Well, I'm not a step guy, but let me throw out some steps. Because the first one is impossible in regards to just you deciding. The first thing you need is to be born again by the Spirit. There's a way that seems right to you, and in the end, it leads to death. Did you hear that? Like, there's a way when you're a sinful man, when you're a sinful woman, when you are born into iniquity, like we covered this morning, there's a way that you see the world that is simply wrong. And when you take all the data and you weigh it out and you make your list of pros and cons, all right, and you get it all set and you go, that's the right decision. What the Bible says is, no, you're way off. You're wrong. That even in your rightness, you're wrong. And so what you need is a new heart that can think rightly about the world around you. And so how is the mind renewed? It's renewed when you're sealed with the promise. It's renewed when you are born again, when you become a believer in Jesus Christ. You can study all the Bible you want and not know Jesus Christ. You can know about him and not know him. Do you understand that? You can know about Jesus Christ and not know him at all. One of my great fears, for I know my people at the Village and for many of you here, is that you would know about Jesus but not know him in such a way that you're actually inoculated to knowing and loving Jesus. Doesn't Jesus tell the Pharisees, you have studied the scriptures in vain because you think that in them you have life, and yet you refuse to come to me to whom those scriptures testify? So why are we in the Word of God? Why are we drawn into the Bible? Because the Bible teaches us about Jesus. And when we behold Jesus and we know Jesus and we love Jesus, then we begin to be transformed. We are becoming like Jesus by beholding Jesus. And that happens more slowly than we would like to admit, doesn't it? I mean, we can be straight. If we can't be honest here, we can't be honest anywhere. That happens more slowly than we would like, right? I think it honestly happens like kids grow. And since I'm guessing most of you don't have kids, let me try to explain that. You can stare at your kids for days and you will never see them grow. You won't. You'll never see them grow. But what happens, let me tell you how you measure it with your first kid. All right, you begin to take stuff. When they start to crawl, you set stuff up a little bit higher. And then they begin to scoot, and so you take it and you move it a little bit higher. And then they learn to climb, and you put it up a little higher. And then they begin to super climb, like rappel, and you spank them. All right? Because you can't nail it to the ceiling. So at that point, you're like, And you discipline in love. Never in anger. Never because you're tired. Never because you told them 6,000 times. All right? 70 times 7. Do the math. That's how you measure it. Or I'll tell you a really weird phenomenon. Maybe you know this because you have nieces or nephews or whatever. It's just like they come downstairs one morning and they doubled in size. Like you never saw them grow. You didn't pick up on anything. And you're like cooking eggs and you look over and your kids got your cell phone, all right? And they're putting an app on it. Like when did that? You were chewing on that phone last week, all right? When did this happen, right? They just It's kind of slow but sure growth. And man, that's how we're transformed. But we're transformed by fixing our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith, whom for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning his shame, and sat down at the right hand of God. Where, listen to this, he makes intercession for you. He prays for you. And so how do you renew your mind? By the grace of God, you're born again. There'll be no renewal of your mind without being born again. So for those of you trying to learn about Jesus but not submit your life to him, look at me, it's not going to work. Trying to implement into your life the moral code of Christianity without the gas of Christianity, the indwelling Holy Spirit, is to have a car with no fuel. It might look pretty, but it doesn't matter when you try to go out in it.